Hey guys, Pete Calamain here. I hope you're having an awesome day. So today I want to explain to you in under 5 minutes how you can design a PCB with an antenna. Now let's look at this example. Say that you are making a Bluetooth device or an LTE connected device, for instance over here with a Nordic module. There is some need of course to go from your module towards an antenna or an antenna connector. In this case, I would like to explain how you make this transmission line or the feed line all the way from the module to your connector. And that can either be a physical connector like this one, a UFL, or maybe an SMD kind of antenna. But there's always a need to have this feed line. Now let's go back to the basics, not the theory, but the applied theory, let's say. Why are we always talking about 50 ohm? So first of all, if we're talking about impedance matching 50 ohms, we are not talking about series resistance or resistance. We are always talking about the complex impedance. Why is that? The main thing, the main idea behind it is that you have a power amplification stage at the output of your RF module. You want to transfer as much power from that stage all the way towards your antenna. And for that, you need to have the complex impedance matched so that as much power as possible is going from the output of your module towards your antenna. If you have an impedance that is mismatched, this will make sure, or this will have the effect that you are losing power in that system between the antenna and the signal generator, let's say, or the output of your module. So power is lost, which means that the effective length of your transmission decreases. So if you're making a Bluetooth system that has, let's say, a typical range of 40 meters with bad matching, that can go or drop to 20 meters, 10 meters, or even below. So today I want to explain to you how we can design these transmission lines. So the line we see over here, this part all the way to the UFL connector, this is a short one, it can be much longer of course. How we can design this and make sure that this 50 ohm impedance that we see, so that we are transferring as much power from the output of the module all the way to the antenna. So this is the basics. There's two ways basically to make that feed line. You can use a microstrip line, which is, I think, in a PCB a more theoretical thing to talk about. The more interesting way to work on a PCB is with a coplanar waveguide. So it means that you are boxing your signal, your feed line towards your antenna, between two ground planes or two ground pores, let's say, along the signal, and there is a ground plane beneath. And that's exactly the case over here. So we have our signal, the feed line, there's two ground pores around it, and then the mid layer below is also grounded. Now, how can we calculate that? First of all, the most important thing that we need for a good calculation is the board stackup. So for instance, if you're using Euro circuits, you can copy that board stackup to your Altium, and then you see clearly where the signal layers are, the thickness of the layer, and especially the thickness of the dielectricum between two layers and the dielectric constant. So in our case, for this stackup, it is 0.12 millimeters, and the dielectric constant is 4.8. Now these values, we can use that in a simple, very simple calculation tool. So this one, I will put the link below in the comments. We can use it to calculate our characteristic impedance. 4.8 is already set. We have a dielectric thickness. So in our case, between, that is our top layer, mid layer, of 0.12. And what we can do is now calculate how this looks like. Of course, there's a track width and a gap width we still need to set. So let's look it up on our PCB, what that is. In this case, our track width is 0.19. And then the distance between that track and the plane is 0.2425. So we have a track width of 0.19. Let's put it at 24. So we see over here, we are at 54, practically 55 ohms. This means we need to increase our track width a bit. Let's try 0.22. And then we drop almost exactly to 50 ohms. So in this case, for this design, all we need to do here is to increase it to 0.22. Make sure, of course, that the pore is a bit further as well, so that the 0.24 remains. And in that case, you have an ideal 50 ohm matched feed line. So very short on how to design a feed line. Next up, we will talk about the matching in that feed line between your system and your antenna. See you soon. Bye-bye.